Welcome to Barnhill Arena on the campus of the University of Arkansas for our live SEC network coverage of women's college gymnastics. Tonight we feature the Georgia Gym Dogs versus the Arkansas Razorbacks. Hi everybody, I'm Bart Connor along with my fellow Olympic medalist Kathy Johnson-Clark broadcasting from our respective home studios. Now Kathy, both of these teams have struggled with COVID protocols and injuries, and frankly I think they both deserve a complete meet tonight, and that's their goal, isn't it?
They certainly do, and I think there's going to be two dynamics really driving a great competition. Both of these teams are looking for their first SEC win. They are also looking for a really high score, and in order to do that, they're going to need to improve on some things.
Let's take a look at the three goals that each of the two teams have identified specifically for tonight.
Georgia coach Courtney Kupetz-Carter told us she wants to see calm, confidence, and aggressive mindset. And better landings this week, and each gymnast has some .025 improvements on each of their events to concentrate on. Arkansas, along with a win, they would like to score in the 197 range and go 6-for-6 on all four events.
Coming up at tonight's meet, we'll also have a chance to visit with Kennedy Hambrick. Talk a little bit about her incredible career. We'll talk to Megan Roberts as well, and we'll be setting up the SEC Gymnastics Championships, which we'll bring to you on the ESPN family of networks on March 19th. A lot more great gymnastics coming up in collegiate competition. But right now, let's go down to our PA announcer and get set for the team intros.
Give it up one more time. They are your best spirit squads in America. Your Arkansas Razorback spirit squads and mascots. Give it up for them, Hawk fans. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome to historic Barnhill Arena, home of your Arkansas Razorbacks. Tonight, we are celebrating our seniors, along with a special thank you to our season ticket holders for their support. But right now, it's time for our opening ceremonies to begin, brought to you by Persil. Let's meet our guests from Athens, Georgia, the Georgia Bulldogs. Competing tonight for Georgia, senior Michaela McGee, junior Soraya Hawthorne, freshman Sarah Cohen, junior Haley DeYoung, senior Emily Shield, junior Amanda Cashman, junior Luli Hadaway, sophomore Victoria Wynn, senior Alyssa Perez Lagunas, senior Rachel Bauman, sophomore Katie Finnegan, senior Megan Roberts, senior Abby Ward, freshman Maeve Hahn, and sophomore Nyla Bryant. The head coach for Georgia, is Courtney Kupitz Carter. Ladies and gentlemen, the Georgia Bulldogs.
Deep within the Ozark Mountains, right in the heart of Fayetteville, look closely and you'll find us.
The Gymbacks. Small in stature, but mighty. Graceful and poised, but fiercely competitive. What do we value? Hard work, respect, trust, family, excellence. Collectively, we bring our talents, passion, heart, and fire. Trained and pushed ourselves far beyond what we thought we were capable of.
We are empowered, strong, and prepared to compete. We've come this far, but we're hungry for more.
It's Friday night in Fayetteville. What is it that we want? To put Arkansas gymnastics on the map.
And make some noise as we welcome to the floor, these are your Arkansas Razorbacks. A freshman from Honolulu, Hawaii, Calista Kamiyao. A freshman from Charlotte, North Carolina, Maddie Jones. A freshman from Coppell, Texas, Frankie Price. A freshman from West Chicago, Illinois, Mackenzie Sedlacek. A freshman from Spring, Texas, Leah Smith. A freshman from Pelham, Alabama, Tammy Weaver. A sophomore from Houston, Texas, Emma Kelly. A sophomore from Parkland, Florida, Jensen Scalzo. A junior from Brownsburg, Indiana, Kiara John Banya. A junior from Sycamore, Illinois, Madison Hickey. A senior from Greensboro, North Carolina, Bailey Lovett. A senior from Austin, Texas, Amanda Senior from Houston, Texas, Kennedy Hambrick. A senior from Parkland, Florida, Abby Johnston. A senior from Houston, Texas, Savannah A graduate student from Lexington, South Carolina, Maggie O'Hara. And a graduate student from Tyler, Texas, Sarah Schaefer. Coaches for the Razorbacks, Kyla Ross, Felicia Hano, and Chris Brooks. And your head coach of the Arkansas Razorbacks is Jordan Weaver. These are your Arkansas Razorbacks! Mm-hmm. Razorback fans, at this time, we ask that you please rise and remove your hats as we honor America and those who protect our freedom with the singing of our national anthem, performed tonight by Melanie Moore. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets rattled, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner
with the national anthem. And now, Razorback fans, let's stand up and call those Hogs.
And over to the SEC Network at 9 p.m. Eastern for this SEC matchup between Arkansas and Georgia. We'll see you over there. Tonight, we feature the Georgia Gym Dogs versus the Arkansas Razorbacks. Hi everyone, I'm Bart Connor, joined by my fellow Olympic medalist Kathy Johnson-Clark, and we're calling this event from our respective home studios. Now Kathy, both of these teams have struggled a bit this year with COVID protocols and injuries. I think they both deserve and need a complete meet tonight, don't they?
I think they certainly do, and I believe we may just have a great competition. Two dynamics could drive that. Both of these teams are looking for their first SEC win this season, and both of these teams need big scores to improve their national ranking.
Now, to that end, they have identified three specific goals that they're shooting for in tonight's competition.
Georgia coach Courtney Coupetz-Carter told us she wants to see calm, confidence, and aggressive mindset, better landings, and each gymnast has some .025 improvements on each of their events they're looking for. Arkansas, along with the win, they would like to score in the 197 range and go 6-for-6 on all four events.
Remind those tuning in about the collegiate gymnastics dual meet rules. Each team puts up 6 gymnasts on each event. You count just the top 5 scores out of those 6 towards the team total. And the home order means what we call the Olympic order. It's vault, bars, beam, and floor. And the home team, Arkansas, will open up on the vault. And the visiting team, Georgia, will open up on the uneven bars. And we will flip-flop back and forth from vault to bars and back and forth throughout the competition. Savannah Panizzi will be the first of the 6 vaulters for Arkansas in tonight's lineup. Arkansas looking for their first SEC win of the season. And this is senior night, so there are 7 seniors who will hopefully have a great competition tonight. And, of course, they'll be celebrated at the end for their incredible career at Arkansas.
The first vault for Arkansas will be a full twist in your chinko that has a start value of 995. Keep in mind that is the maximum score that this vault can earn. The judges are looking for amplitude, height and distance from the table, also perfect form and that ideal shape in the air. This is a layout vault. You want to see no pike in the hips. Tight body. Big height and a nice flare open to really finish that vault. So cleanly, looked like great distance. I really love the pop up off the table. Only a slight pike in the hips on the vault and a slight adjustment on the landing.
Benizi, the senior from Porter, Texas, has really blossomed as a walk-on here, learned so many skills and contributed a great deal to this program in her career as a Razorback. Now you see the lineup there for the Georgia Gym Dogs. Amanda Cashman, the junior out of New Jersey, will lead them off here. Her season high is a 9.775.
She opens this routine with a single bar release move, comes up right here. It's called a Tkachev, so it's out of a giant swing, flies backwards over the bar. Nice job on that handstand, as well as the bail to handstand right on top of the bar. Little bit of a sway in the back on that final handstand. Double layout, a very quick stick, we would call that. Not quite a complete control on the landing. She turned to salute the judge really quickly to not move her feet. Judges are looking for the height. That could be a little bit higher and more rotated for absolutely no deduction. Look at the landing, though. Just a little quick to that salute.
And we'll go back to the vault now for Arkansas. You see the score came in for Benizi, a 9.8. Leah Smith, the freshman from Spring, Texas, having an incredible year.
Very nice open position after that full. Looked like she might have been slightly piked and had a hop on the landing. Nice height, even higher than the previous vault, just that scoot on the landing. But good height and nice open hips throughout that layout full.
Leah Smith trained at the World Champion Center, along with Simone Biles, one of the most dominant gymnasts in the history of the sport. I'm sure some of her expertise rubbed off on Leah. Haley DeYoung now, the junior from Vancouver, Canada. Last year was a top contributor to Georgia on vault, bars, and beam especially.
Haley opens with a toe handstand first on the high bar and then into her single bar release move, which is slim, similar to the Tkachev we saw in the first routine, except she'll do it from a toe on, meaning put the toes on the bar to circle around before releasing the bar.
Her season high is a 9.875. There is Courtney Kupetz-Carter in her fifth year at Georgia. Had a legendary career as an elite athlete, Olympic medalist, and NCAA champion many times over. And now in her fifth season here at Georgia. The mother of three, soon to be the mother of four, Kathy. Her fourth child is due in July, so she has plenty on her hands these days, doesn't she?
This long wait is almost similar to icing the kicker in football. She's just standing there going over the cues in her mind.
They were waiting on the score from the previous athlete. That's in now, Amanda Cashman, a 9.75 in the leadoff spot. Here's DeYoung.
Here's the toe on to the handstand. Now she'll toe on again into the reverse heck. Good height, but a little too close. When she caught the bar, she had to bend the arms. Slight leg separation on the bail handstand on low bar. Nice job putting that final handstand right on top of the bar. It's a double layout. Good lift on that second somersault, especially.
Sarah Schaefer, the graduate student from Tyler, Texas, set to go now. Score for Leah Smith before her, a 9.85. So Arkansas so far, a 9.8 and a 9.85 for their two first two vaulters.
Vasilyarchenko with a half twist. Really nice open floaty position in the air. A pretty large hop on the landing, so that will be the most significant deduction there.
Josh Overton in his fifth year at Georgia. He has been responsible for the good work they've done on the bars. Katie Finnegan, the sophomore from New York, getting set to go. Still waiting on the score for Haley DeYoung.
Last week, Katie Finnegan had really nice handstand positions in her routine and a sky-high Ray. That's her single bar release move. So we're hoping to see that good amplitude here as well.
She only did the uneven bars three times last year for Georgia. This year, season high of 9-9, so contributing a lot. Scores in for Haley DeYoung. It's a 9-8-2-5.
Good handstand sets up her Ray. That is really nicely done.
That was huge.
Nice to see those arms extended for the regrasp. Ooh, leg separation on the pack salto down to the low bar. Good control on that half pirouette. Finessing these handstands nicely. Now, this is a full twisting double back. Excellent landing. Check this out from the side. Really beautiful height and rotation to get that thing turned over nicely. Good control on that full twisting double back. Well done.
We'll go back to vault for Arkansas. Sarah Schaefer had their second 9-8-5 in a row. That brings up senior Amanda Ellswick from Austin, Texas. You see her season vault average there. Her season high is a 9-9.
Remember, they're looking for better landings here. Really, really nice job on the Yurchenko full. Good height and distance. Nice balance between the two.
And we welcome our audience joining us now. We're in Barn Hill Arena here at the campus of the University of Arkansas. It's the Georgia Gym Dogs visiting the Arkansas Razorbacks. We are in the first of four rotations. Arkansas, the home team, opening up on vault, and Georgia on the bars. I'm Bart Connor, along with Kathy Johnson Clark. We're broadcasting tonight from our respective home studios. And at the top of the show, Kathy, both of these teams identified some specific goals that they're shooting for. Obviously, they are hungry for their first win in the SEC this season. And so one of those teams will accomplish that goal tonight, and we'll identify some of the other focus for the teams as we go throughout the competition. You see the scores there for Georgia so far on bars. They're high so far. Katie Finnegan's 9-8-7-5.
This could be a big routine for Emily Shield. Like how she has the big straddle shape in that single bar release move. A little bit short on that bail handstand on low bar. They really want to see these handstands in perfect vertical position. She was a little bit shy of that final handstand. Big double layout. She does that slightly different technique. Really tries to keep her body completely straight like a pencil.
Here are some of the team goals that we mentioned, Kathy.
Courtney Kupatz Carter really wants to see her athletes calm, confident, but with an aggressive mindset. Trying to find that balance is the challenge. She wants to see better landings. And all of the gymnasts here have these .025 improvements in mind on every event they're trying to achieve here.
Here's freshman Mackenzie Sedlacek.
A 1.5 twist. That's the first 10-0 start value vault we've seen in the competition so far. Nice combination of height and distance.
She's coming up just after Amanda Ellswick had a career-high 9-9. Megan Roberts will be next to go after they get the score in for Emily Shield. Georgia yet to break into the 9-9s, but good scores there from 9-7-5 to 9-8-7-5 so far.
The previous routines we've seen on uneven bars, they've all done single bar release moves to earn those bonus points necessary to have a 10-0 start value on the uneven bars. Megan actually does transitions, flight transitions from low to high and back down to low to get those bonus points. She'll open with a toe handstand right here into another toe on. Maloney up to the high bar. Good swing into the bail. Slightly bent arms on that cast and a little shy of handstand. Double layout. Gorgeous shape in the air. Just that hop back will be another deduction.
Here is legendary coach Courtney Kupetz-Carter, just in her fifth season as Georgia. I say legendary because she is a world champion, Olympic medalist two times over, many times All-American, and of course, she never lost a team championship when she was competing for the Georgia Gym Dogs, and now she is their head coach. Here is senior Kennedy Hambrick from Pearland, Texas.
This is a one and a half twist, and she is really focused on improving the landing this competition. Slight hop forward. She had under-rotated the vault the last time out, so she really wanted to make sure she got full block and get that complete rotation. She was a little bit soft on form, bent her legs slightly going into the landing. Just making sure to not under-rotate this week.
Hambrick, the senior on senior night. Seven seniors for Arkansas will be celebrated tonight. She was their anchor vaulter in this first rotation coming after Mackenzie Selachek had a 9.75. That will be the score they hope to drop. So far, the high score for Arkansas on vault is Amanda Ellswick's 9.9. Victoria Wynn now, the sophomore from Houston, Texas, coming after Megan Roberts, got a 9.825.
Unique combination here, toe handstand to a Higgins turn after the second toe hand right into a Pike Jaeger. Very difficult combination. Pack salto down to low bar, slight leg separation in the pack. Nice job finessing that final handstand. Here's the dismount, double layout. Just a hop in place on that landing. So for a perfect landing, the feet really have to stay glued to the mat. She doesn't hop forward or back, which is a good thing, just up and down, so they'll take a tiny, tiny deduction for that.
Well, when we come back, Kathy chats with Arkansas senior Kennedy Hambrick on her experience at Nationals last season and her favorite memory as a gym bag here on senior night.
Kennedy, before we talk about this season, I want to touch on last season. You had a phenomenal junior season. Qualified to Nationals as an individual, second team All-American in three events in the all-around. Tell us about that experience, and is it an inspiration to get back there again, perhaps with your team this year?
Last year it was amazing. I can just hope to move forward and keep going and rise. Nationals was so fun. I hope we can make it there with my team this year, because that was just an amazing experience, and I would love for the rest of my team to experience that too.
When it comes to resumes, you guys have a stacked coaching staff. Can you describe each of your coaches and how they differ?
Jordan, she can be very serious about the gymnastics, and she knows all the technical things that we need to hear. But then if you compare her to Chris, He is just so funny all the time. Fish, she is our vault coach. So every day I go talk to her and see what's up and what we're gonna do on vault today. And she breaks down everything that we need to do. Kyla, very funny. Having her on beam, she's helped me calm down a little bit because I used to be super shaky and really nervous. But she's talked me through the things that have helped her and I've put them into my gymnastics and it's helped me as well.
So it's senior night. What's your favorite memory looking back over your years?
Last year, whenever I broke the school record, I didn't even realize that I had done it until they announced it. It was just so overwhelming and I was so happy and everyone was cheering. I think I even cried a little bit. I was just so excited.
All right, rotation one is complete. Kennedy Hambrick, the four-time All-American, has a season high of 9.925 on bars. We'll see if she can equal that or better it as Arkansas heads to the bars in rotation two. Georgia will be on the vault. Remarkable elite career in the early 2000s, culminating with two medals in the 2004 Athens Olympics. She also won a bars gold medal in the 2002 World Championships and was a two-time U.S. all-around champion. And then she went on to college and broke nearly every record in women's collegiate gymnastics. Look at this, four consecutive team championships with Georgia. She never lost while she was on their team. The NCAA title, scored eight tens, at least one on every event, becoming one of the most decorated NCAA gymnasts of all time. And now she is the head honcho at Georgia in her fifth season. We talked with her earlier this week, Kathy, and she wasn't sure she was going to be able to put up six athletes on each event. They have struggled with a number of things, including COVID and injuries, and yet they're putting together a respectable season at this point.
I know she must be pleased so far. Season high on their first event, uneven bars. They really want to follow that up with improved landings. Use that
Amanda Cashman
calm, aggressive mentality to attack these vaults and wait for the landing.
Oh.
Big fall. Very nicely done. No movement of the feet. Her chest was a little bit forward on the landing. But already you're seeing the 0.025 improvements they're talking about. They wanted to focus on getting these landings better. And so far, they're off to a great start.
Arkansas has the lead by just 1/10 of a point as we go into the second of four rotations. Leah Smith, the freshman from Spring, Texas, will lead them off on the bars. Her season high here is a 9.85. Last week, only a 9.3 in this event.
She overshot this pack salto right here last week, or the bail. So far, very good. A little bit short on that final handstand. Big dismount, double layout. Slid her feet back on the landing, so they'll take a slight deduction there as well. But a solid start for Arkansas.
Here is Jordan Weber, who herself has had a legendary career as an elite athlete. Third season as the Arkansas head coach. All three seasons severely affected by COVID protocols. She'll be due a clean season one of these days soon. Back to the vault.
Michaela McGee doing a 1.5 twist, 10-0 start value. Just that step to the side on the landing.
Jensen Scalzo will be next up for Arkansas on the bars, the sophomore from Florida. Score is in now for Leah Smith. It's a strong 9.8.
Jensen was a little bit short on all of her handstands. last week, so she really wants to be patient, finish these kips, and get those handstands on top of the bar. She was slightly shy again on that first one. Nice position on that Jaeger salto. The single bar release, good distance from the bar, just a teeny bit shy of the handstands this week. Good lift on that double layout and a fine landing.
Three times she scored 9-9 on this event this year.
Here's that straddle Jaeger. She could have been a little bit higher, but she was the perfect distance from the bar. I love the lift they get on their double layouts. Really lifts into that second somersault.
Abby Ward next to go. Quick update on the scores. Amanda Cashman hit a 9.775. Michaela McGee, 9.85.
This is a different looking vault. No round off onto the board. It's a traditional entry called a kazematsu.
Oh,
wow,
what a landing.
What a landing. A very difficult vault. Often women call this a Sugihara full. She's actually doing a kazematsu, so it's kind of a quarter on, three quarter off in that layout. Very difficult, hard to generate the power.
Oh. Courtney knows how good that was. Abby's been struggling with a little bit of calf tightness this week, so I think they're very impressed with that landing. Maddie Jones will be next up for Arkansas on the bars, the freshman from North Carolina. Season high in this event for her is a 9.925. She got that last week.
You can really see her doing the visualization, seeing the skills in her mind, going over the strong cues that they train every single day in the gym.
Coach Weber said she's really spectacular walk-on athlete. She's beautiful on this event as well as floor. And in many ways, she's been setting the tone with her work ethic in the gym, just as a freshman.
Watch this beautiful giant swing into a blind change right here. Half turn on top of the bar, a little pass vertical into a very difficult pike Jaeger. Really shows off that pack salto beautifully, kept those legs glued together. So far, excellent work on this event. Maybe a tiny bit shy of the final handstand. Double layout. She got the stick. I thought she might have released just a little early and took it out, but she found that landing. Well done. So this pack salto is gorgeous. So well done. Perfect form. And the double layout, slightly deep in the bend of the knees, but held on for the stick.
She got congratulations there from Chris Brooks in his third season as the assistant coach. He himself an Olympian. Saraya Hawthorne now.
Doing the full today. 9.95 start bell. She's training the 1.5, and you can see she's got the power and the height and rotation to certainly do the 1.5, but they went for the full.
Sunday at 2 Eastern right here on the SEC Network. The number one South Carolina women's basketball team heads to Ole Miss for the team's last game for the SEC Women's Basketball Tournament. Also available on the ESPN app. Kennedy Hambrick set to go. You see her season average there. Update on the scores there. Maddie Jones, 9.85 after Jensen Scalzo's 9.825. Leah Smith started them off with a 9.8. So the scores are building nicely. And many times, Kathy, that is the strategy with the coaching staff, is to put in a solid, clean hit routine and build from there, isn't it?
Absolutely. And keep in mind, the score that they're looking for team is right around that 197, if not higher. That's a 9.85 average. So they're doing pretty well. They need slightly bigger scores in the last half of the lineup now.
That means for every 9.8 that counts, you need a 9.9 to keep that average at 9.85, because they would like to hit that 197 mark today.
Giant blind. into a pike. High in the air, but just mistimed the release. So it went, took the skill a little too far away from the bar. So much swing was going back away, and she just could not get her grips on top of the bar. Only the fingertips, and you really have to get that dowel that's in the grip over the bar so that you can hold on. 0.5 of a point off for the fall.
Hambrick was out last week because of COVID protocols, and coaching staff acknowledged that sometimes when an athlete's out for a week or so, it affects lots of things, their timing, their focus, and even their endurance.
She's going to start from the beginning because she needs this skill, this connection for her start value. Well done. Really trying to finesse those handstands. She's a little bit short of the vertical, but way to go. She just repeated her entire routine, but unfortunately, it'll be 0.5 of a point lower because of the fall.
Rachel Bauman set to go, the senior from Plano, Texas. Soraya Hawthorne, only a 9.675, couldn't quite control that landing. Bauman, season high, is a 9.95 on this event.
And she's doing a 1.5 this season. I love seeing it. She was so determined to upgrade to this. Oh, almost held on for the stick. Couldn't quite keep those feet down, had to step forward quickly, but this is a really good vault. Slight leg separation on the table and almost held on for the stick, went up on her toes and then had to step forward. Much better to step and take a small step forward than back, however.
The time to remind the audience here tuning in that six athletes compete for each team on each event. You have the opportunity to drop the lowest of those six scores. So Kennedy Hambrick's fall hopefully will be the only low score, and they'll have five respectable scores. You can see Sarah Schaefer has been a bit inconsistent on this event as well this year.
She was a little bit tight last week on her handstands, which usually means just a little nerves.
Hambrick scores a 9.35.
And be aggressive here. Nice job on that first handstand. Look at those pencils straight. Oh, no.
Wow, that's a surprise.
Nerves are definitely creeping in a little bit. This is when they need to do a reset. Take a deep breath. She just rushed it. Went to reach before you get the lift off of the out of the skill, out of the toe on. You really have to get lift the center of gravity up high enough before you start reaching for the bar.
Twice this year, she scored 9.925 on this event. Does mean that they'll have to count a fall in this rotation. Remember, Arkansas
Much
had a
better.
Slight lead, 1/10 of a point over Georgia after the first rotation. And they're going to squander that lead here if Georgia can continue to hit their vaults cleanly.
And this is a beautiful routine because she started from the very beginning, had to take a step forward on that landing. They're fully capable of these routines. What they have to figure out is how to manage the pressure in competition, the nerves, the anticipation. Sometimes it's a matter of they want it so badly you can overtry instead of just be normal. Do what you do in training.
Megan Roberts will be the final vaulter for Georgia. Rachel Bauman had a 9.875. A hit vault here could secure Georgia the lead in the team competition at the halfway point, probably.
This is where she wants to improve. On the landing, held on to that landing. Really well done. Interesting to see what the judges would see. They sit on the side, so they get a different view. Let's see if her feet move. Just a slight hop in place, almost kept those toes down. They'll take a slight deduction there, but a big improvement.
So two missed routines for Arkansas on bars. Kennedy Hambrick's score was a 9.35. Sarah Schaefer's score is now in. It's a 9.25, so they'll have to count that 9.35, assuming Maggie O'Hara scores higher. So Arkansas will have to count one fall in five of the six scores here. A lot of pressure on Maggie O'Hara to have a big score right now, and she can deliver here.
And she needs to embrace that pressure situation. Go for,
Wow. Can't believe I'm seeing this.
This, unfortunately, is just a matter of nerves. When you've had mistakes in front of you, you can put too much pressure trying to get too much done. And this is unfortunate, and it's going to be a learning situation for them when they go back in the gym, because you'll see they are fully capable of these routines. Nice job on that handstand on low bar. Nice aggressive final cast. Good for her. Double layout. Gorgeous position in the air. So there was a lot of good work in this rotation. They will have to go back to the gym and figure this out. This is just something only they can do.
Maybe they're feeling a little extra pressure on senior night here, because those are the kind of mistakes that you see typically from a rookie, but these are experienced gymnasts who had a little difficulty in the second rotation. So Arkansas has put themselves in a difficult situation at the halfway point. They're going to have to go to beam and try to get this back together, because they will count two low scores in that second rotation. Georgia solid on vault. Their high score there was Megan Roberts, 9.9, to cap off that rotation. Let's go down to Courtney Kupetz-Carter.
Hello
there. So we talked in the interview about those .025s and better landings. Tell me what you saw, Coach.
I'm so proud of them right now. They're being very intentional with everything we worked on this week, and you can see it. And they're excited. They're building. And so we just want to keep doing that through the next two rotations.
So next event, floor exercise, what's the advice to them?
Yeah, we focus on those landings, but at the same time, if you focus on them, you're not going to get what you want. So the idea here is just they focus on their takeoffs on each of their passes.
Thank you. Good luck.
Thank you.
After the break, Kathy talks to Georgia's senior Megan Roberts about what drew her to the Gym Dogs and what message that she has for younger gymnasts.
Megan, so many great Canadian gymnasts have come to the U.S. over the years to compete collegiate gymnastics. When did you first become interested, and what made you choose Georgia?
So it actually was Brittany Rogers, which I'm sure you guys know was very successful. I was on the Canadian national team at the time with her because she was doing the college and elite gymnastics thing. Originally, I talked to her about it. Georgia was the school that she was at the time, and so she like went on and on about it. Once I came to campus, I actually didn't even end up visiting any other schools because I loved Georgia so much when I got here.
How would you describe your own personal growth and maturity with the many, many challenges you and your teammates have faced?
I can definitely say I'm a different person than I was freshman year. I was able to learn time management and able to deal with adversity and kind of push through that and feel more confident with myself. I think one of the biggest things that I learned was kind of what I liked outside of gymnastics. And for a while, I kind of didn't know what I wanted to do in school. And it wasn't until I took PR and advertising classes and I was like, oh, like, I really like this. And it took off a little bit of stress in the gym because I wasn't like, my entire life depends on gymnastics.
How do you encourage young girls out there to kind of refocus how they define success?
I would kind of just give them advice to focus on little things that they want to fix. Kind of like Courtney says, the .025s. And I would really say to just take a step back and enjoy each moment and don't look at it in the grand scheme of things, but focus in on each day and what you can improve on to kind of be a better version of you.
Thank you, Kathy and Megan. And when we come back, Megan and Georgia will head to the floor for Rotation 3 here on Friday Night Heights. We're live in Fayetteville, Arkansas. Third of four rotations. When we come back, Georgia has the lead by a point. Member of the gold medal-winning Fierce Five team at the 2012 Olympics, Jordan Weber, was also the 2011 World All-Around Champion. She won the U.S. All-Around titles in 2010 and 11 before going on to be a student coach at UCLA while she got her bachelor's degree in psychology. Now, Kathy, if there's ever a contest of our coaches have more medals than your coaches, well, Arkansas wins hands down. Between Jordan Weber, Chris Brooks, Felicia Hano, and Kyla Ross, they have won 12 NCAA titles, 10 world medals, and 2 Olympic medals. There's no contest, huh?
Not even close.
Big expectations for the team at Arkansas, and boy, they have put themselves in a bit of a hole after that rough rotation on the bars with 3 falls. Remember, they led by 1/10 over Georgia after the first rotation, but those 3 falls have hurt them a great deal. So Georgia leads. Georgia will be on floor in this rotation, and the Razorbacks on the beam, and they need to be spectacular here.
And their beam coach is the beam queen, Kyla Ross. She knows how to calm the nerves, stay focused. And I know when we spoke with Kennedy Hambrick, she said that was one of the things that Kyla did for her.
Calixta Gamiao, the freshman from Hawaii.
Watch this. I love the combination. Standing, layout, step out to layout, step out. Very solid. Side summy. Beautiful position, nice toes on those leaps. The judges look for that full 180 degree split. I love how calm and confident she looks throughout this routine, very deliberate. All the way through to the dismount, 1.5 twist and a stick way to turn the page after bars and get them started on beam, exactly what you wanted to see.
He's only been in the lineup 2 times for Arkansas on the beam, and a important hit to get the momentum back. And now on Alyssa Perez Lugones, you see she's the leadoff performer for Georgia on the floor. The senior from Duluth, Georgia, she has been quite comfortable in that leadoff spot. Season high 985 on floor.
And I just love this music and the way she performs and showcases her unique style. She does 2 double backs in this routine. The first one in pike position here. Good lift, good control. New pass for whip half, front full. Fortunately, she wasn't quite in control on that landing. Finish this high energy routine with a double back in tuck position. Well, first and last pass, she showed off good landings. They'll have to take a deduction on that middle tumbling run where she took the large jumping step out of.
Sunday night at 8 Eastern, we'll have a 3.5-hour recap of this weekend's SEC Indoor Track and Field Championships. The Arkansas Razorbacks are the defending men's and women's champs. It's all right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Maggie O'Hara now, let's see if she can recover from that difficult routine on the bars here. Three falls for Arkansas in that second rotation. 9.85 was the score for Calixta Gamiao. Great start for Arkansas here.
And this is only Maggie's second competitive beam routine this season. Side aerial to back handspring, just slightly doubted herself for a split second instead of finishing strong. But as I said, this is only the second time in competition. She had a huge hip surgery in the off season. Nice job on those leaps and jumps. And this is the event it took her longer to get back to after that surgery.
Graduate student in movement science. She's a transfer from Michigan.
Cartwheel, 1.5 twist. That's a new dismount for her. You don't often see a cartwheel into the 1.5 twist. Usually you'll see a round off. So really happy to see her pull this off, because that she undoubtedly was feeling a lot of nerves, a lot of pressure after the uneven bar, so great recovery.
Michaela McGee coming after Alyssa Perez Lugones had a 9.8 to start them off. McGee, the senior from Texas, season high 9.9 here.
A little devil went down to Georgia for a hot minute there to start. Pike full twisting double back, very difficult. Combination pass, back 1.5, front layout, good control. Very precise footwork. Double pike for the last pass. Nice form in the air. Great control on the landing. Good routine. Really well done. I love the very clean, precise footwork. Beautiful toe point, even in the tumbling. To maintain that toe point and perfectly straight legs in a difficult tumbling pass, love to see it.
Leah Smith will be next to go for Arkansas on beam. Gamio had a 9.85, O'Hara 9.775. Smith, her season high here is a 9.9.
Nice opening with the candle mount right to that vertical position. Switch leap to a straddle quarter, needs a little bit more split in the air. Acrobatic series, back handspring layout, step out, a little soft in the back knee. difficult dismount here. Always fun to see double back and a perfect landing.
Oh, that was
great. Well done.
What technique and power.
Really nice. This is the angle that the judges see. So you can see the legs are a little bit soft. The form isn't quite perfect in that layout with the toes and the knees. But wow, what a finish. Grand finale, double back dismount, and a great landing.
Haley DeYoung. Michaela McGee, 9825.
I love that Courtney told me she wanted her to turn down the warrior dial, not to get so amped up on this first pass, especially triple full, really difficult.
Oh,
see, she's just a little over amped there. That leg up just a little bit higher in that wolf jump. Comes back with a double back, tuck position. Oh, and a stuck landing. I mean, who doesn't love Footloose? This is fun. Combination pass. Oh, mistimed. Oh, that's too bad. Oh, she had a great routine going and just mistimed the punch between the 1.5 twist and the front layout. This is beautiful, but she just needs to block back a little bit further going into the triple twist so she doesn't over-rotate it. And right there, she was just flat-footed on the punch between the 1.5 and the layout and couldn't lift it up high enough.
Bailey Lovett now on beam for Arkansas. Leah Smith, a 9-9. That's a season high for her. So Arkansas, who put themselves in a bit of a hole after some missed routines on bars, responding well here on beam.
Difficult combination, front aerial to back layout step out. Very difficult to keep those two connected. To get credit for the connection, and it's her acro series, so very crucial part of the routine. Pretty position on those leaps and jumps. Full split, legs straight and toes pointed.
Jordan Weber told us, Kathy, that Bailey is always asking after the meets are over, can I get one of the judges' summary? I want to see what they're taking off so that I can focus on those details next week.
Absolutely love it. Ha, get that? Love it. That was unintentional, but fun. Yeah, just a little soft on that one leg in the front aerial. That's being picky because I do love that combination. And the side aerial into the full twist. And that's the kind of perfectionism you need. You need to know what the judges are seeing, what they're deducting. Go back and see if you can find those little tiny tenths of a point by improving.
Megan Roberts now for Georgia on the floor. Haley DeYoung score just a 9-0. Remember, Georgia had a lead of 1 point coming into this rotation.
It's going to open with a combination pass front through to double back. Very nice landing. Three leap series here. Switch side, popa into a wolf full.
Thank you.
ends with a difficult pike double back. You get bonus for doing the double back, and the pike is much more difficult. Little awkward on that landing, kind of bounced out of it, a little stiff-legged. Strong routine. I think that really the main deduction will be that final tumbling run, that landing. She didn't quite absorb the landing. The first one was the combination, the front through to a tuck double back. Really good control. Notice how she kept that front foot down. Now watch here. Legs are a little stiff, so she doesn't absorb this landing. She bounces it.
Courtney Coupette's in her fifth season. They were only 18th place last year in the NCAA rankings. That's their lowest finish since 1983. Of course, Georgia, 10-time national champions, hoping to regain that glory. We go back now to Arkansas on the beam. 9-9 was the score for Kennedy Hambrick, their second 9-9 in a row. Just what they need. Bailey Lovett had a 9-9. This is Hambrick.
Back handspring layout, step out. Oh, she saved it. She had so much momentum on that series. And when you do that, you really have to aggressively attack the landing to freeze it in that lunge position and then press down into the beam. Beat jump into a straddle three-quarter. Difficult second jump there. I'll tell you what, she has fought through this routine. I could see the nerves on her face, but she managed it, saved that series on the beam. It'll be a pretty significant deduction, but so glad she fought. Notice how the heel was kind of slipped off to the side of the beam, and sometimes you can overcome that if you're just really aggressive on the finish after the skill.
Rachel Bauman scored a perfect 10 on floor this year.
All of the pieces just came together. She has difficult tumbling and dance, like this opening wolf turn. Count them. One, two, did a 2.5. Difficult combination pass here. She's going to twist both elements. Back 1.5 here to a front full. Excellent control.
Remember, Georgia's trying to replace that 9-0 score in their rotation here. They need two more hit routines, this one from Bauman and the next one from Hawthorne, to hold their lead. They had 1-point lead coming into this third rotation over Arkansas.
Double pike dismount here. Nice. Very strong routine. It's a two-pass routine, and because she twists both elements on the combination pass, really gets good bonus there, which you need to do if you're going to do a two-pass routine. Then she does the pike double back at the end, 10th of a point bonus for doing a double back, and the more difficult pike double back really boosts the value of the routine.
Very important routine here for Arkansas now. Amanda Ellswick, 9.675 was the score for Kennedy Hambrick. That is their low score that they'd like to drop. They have two 9.9s from Smith and Lovett, and Ellswick has the potential to score big here. Her season high is a 9.95.
judges are looking for amplitude and form. Nice straight legs. The extra step at the end of that series will be a slight deduction. Slightly soft knees on that back leg in the first leap. Difficult second jump. Front aerial, very solid. Calm, confident routine. Finishes with a back handspring to 1.5 twist. What a turnaround for this team. It's a really difficult thing to come back from a disastrous uneven bar rotation. Love the form on that. Very floaty in the layout. Straight legs. Nice lift on that 1.5 twist and a perfect landing. Look at the emotion. So wonderful.
That is the anchor performer for Arkansas on the beam. They will have 5 solid scores to add into their team total, as Saraya Hawthorne scored a 9.675 on vault earlier. Couldn't quite control her landings. Let's see if she can do well here. Coming after Rachel Bauman, a 9.925. Georgia still in the lead, the team competition.
I know they're hoping for 3 really solid landings in this routine. First one on the double black, pike position.
Oh.
Perfect landing. Chest up high. People may remember UCLA great floor performer Stella Ume does all the choreography of these routines for Georgia. Difficult leaps, needs a little bit more split in the air. Front layout to Rudy. A switch split jump. Strong routine and great performance quality. Look at the landing. The height on the skill, and look how high her chest is when she lands. There's no lean forward. 1.5 twist to the split jump. Arm circle just a little bit to stay balanced before the landing.
Let's go down to Jordan Weber.
So Jordan Weber, what a comeback on beam. I know bars, it's gonna be back to the drawing board, but tell me what you think about this team's performance.
Well, we had an incredible start on vault. Multiple people stuck. I was really proud of that. Some shakiness on bars. I think a little bit of trying to be perfect because it's senior night, but I'm really proud of the way they turned it around on beam, and I just told the team, let's start a party on floor and finish this thing strong.
So I've called you the floor whisperer. What have you whispered in their ears as they go to floor now?
Confidence. Go big, land strong, smile, and put on a show for the crowd.
Oh, thank you so much. Good luck to you.
Thank you so much.
3.99s for Arkansas. What a recovery on beam in that third rotation. They will still trail, though. However, Georgia has a solid lead. We'll be back for the fourth and final rotation. Going on tonight in the SEC.
And for Alabama, Louisa Blanco, a superb earning season high scores on vault. This 9.95 on bars and a season high on floor exercise. She is the epitome of an all-around gymnast. Lit the floor up. The audience loves her performance. And a season high 39.725 in the all-around.
That was their win over Missouri tonight for Alabama. Sunisa Lee, the Olympic champion, had a big night for Auburn.
She started her NCAA season career strong and has only gotten better. Look at this uneven bar routine, a 9.975, as close to perfection as you can get. And then she one-upped herself on balance beam with a 10.0 and a huge smile.
A lot of exciting things happening in the SEC. Look at this, five SEC teams in the Road to Nationals top 10. They're, of course, Florida, Auburn, LSU, Alabama, and Missouri. Florida clinched a share of the regular season SEC title last week. That means they could win it outright if they have a win over Auburn next week. Auburn scores program record 197.925 with Suni Lee's perfect 10. Great night for Auburn as well. Now, Saturday, March 19th, don't miss the SEC Gymnastics Championship from Birmingham, Alabama. The afternoon session will start at 3:30 Eastern with the night session and the top four seeds going at 8 Eastern. It's all going to be right here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Kathy Johnson-Clark, you and I will be there in Birmingham bringing you 4 hours of exciting SEC championships on March 19th. Here are the current SEC standings. You see Florida, Auburn, LSU, and Kentucky, the top four. They will compete in the evening session based on those rankings. And then Missouri, Alabama, Arkansas, and Georgia will compete in the afternoon session. So lots more exciting gymnastics coming up on the SEC Network. Georgia has the lead as we get ready to go into the fourth and final rotation here from Fayetteville. Welcome back to Fayetteville. Bart Connor along with Kathy Johnson-Clark. Here is the meet summary after three rotations. Arkansas led by a tenth after the first rotation, and then three falls on the uneven bars has been the story of the meet for Arkansas. Georgia took the lead by a point, and now they continue to lead by just under a point as we go into the final rotation. Of course, Arkansas will be on the floor in front of their home crowd, and the visiting Georgia Gym Dogs will finish on the beam. Michaela McGee gets the leadoff performance for Georgia here. Season high 9.9 for her.
And watch her beautiful, strong feet throughout this entire routine. She has beautiful footwork, excellent beam posture. Triple series here, back handspring to two layout, or two back handsprings to layout step out, very solid. Oh, so beautiful. Up on toe on the full turn throughout the entire turn sequence, in and out of the full turn. Round off 1.5 twist. Oh, just that little step right there. Slight deduction, just a superb beam routine. Watch how straight her legs are throughout. Even in slow motion, perfectly pointed toes throughout. Really nice job.
Savannah Panisi for Arkansas, trailing Georgia by just under a point. They need to be spectacular here if they're going to make this one close. And they're going to have to hope that Georgia struggles a bit on beam.
She wants to improve on this first pass from last week. It's a front double full. It's an E element.
Oh!
Under-rotated. One and a half front layout, much better on this pass. Yeah. Final pass, round off double back, chest a little bit low on the landing. So unfortunately a fall in the first pass. This will end up being the score they hope to drop. So they'll need 5 hit routines, but also a lot of good things in that routine as well. Good control on the landing, that middle pass.
Go back to beam now for Georgia. Saraya Hawthorne waits her turn, and talk about the beam bounce back for Georgia. Look at this. January 21st, they had a score of 46.625, and since then, every week they have improved. February 18th, a 49.35, a very strong team score on beam. So they are trending in the right direction, according to Courtney Coupetz-Carter. And this year, even though they haven't put a complete meet together as a team, 11 athletes have scored career highs. Courtney told us the other day, Kathy, it's like a movie trailer. It entices you, but we haven't put the whole movie together yet.
It's getting close, though. They're having a really, really good competition. And I love seeing the improvement on balance beam from week to week, because it could have been extremely demoralizing to begin the season that way and then to just steadily keep doing the work. And the work is obvious. You see it in their performances now. I see it in their confidence approach to the routine.
Ten times Georgia has won that NCAA team title. Those titles came under Suzanne Yocklin.
1.5 twists, step forward, but such a solid routine. As I said, you can really see that they have put the work in the gym and the confidence that they're showing. And going big, really exploding into those leaps, needs a little bit more split in the air.
Georgia has a couple of wins this year, but none of them in away meets. And so today, the opportunity to get a win in the SEC and a respectable away score, which will factor into how they qualify for the postseason.
Maddie Jones is going to open with the same pass we saw Savannah attempt. The front double full. Very nicely done.
Score for Panizzi, only a 9-1. So Arkansas needs 5 hit routines now.
Back 1.5, front layout. Felicia Hano is the floor coach, does all the choreography, selects the music. She was, of course, a wonderful performer in her own right for UCLA. Switch ring to switch half. Switch half needed a little bit more amplitude and a little more rotation. She'll end with a Rudy, which is a 1.5 twist. Nice routine.
Monday night SEC Inside grants you an all-access pass to the Tennessee men's basketball program at 7 Eastern. Then it's a look at the Texas A&M women's team at 7:30. You'll get never-before-seen footage and sound from players and coaches, only here on the SEC Network and the ESPN app. Emily Shield now coming after 2 season and career-high scores on beam. For Michaela McGee with a 9.9 and Saraya Hawthorne a 9.875.
Mounted with a press handstand, showing off strength, flexibility, and balance. Front aerial to the back handspring, back handspring. That's her series. connected all three elements without hesitation. Switch leap to split jump. Really straight legs. Cat leap side aerial to the full. Another hit routine. Whoo, you could see her take that big breath at the end. You could see there was a little bit of stress in that routine, and she calmed herself throughout, kept it all together, finished strong.
Jordan Weber told us, Arkansas's coach, just this week, she said, you know, it's been a little bit difficult to get some momentum going. They had postponed meets and schedule changes and COVID protocols and injuries. She said, we really haven't quite been able to get it all together. And unfortunately, the nerves have gotten to some of their gymnasts tonight to see if freshman Mackenzie Sedlacek can deliver a solid routine here. Season high for her, a 9-9, four times she's been in the lineup on floor.
Full twisting double back to open. Another E pass, really well done. One and a half to front layout. Nice position in those leaps. Finishes strong with a double back. Boy, I love the way they have come back. Full twisting double back. She's deceivingly powerful. Nice job on that double back. Really tried to finesse getting the chest up on the landing.
Interesting that the nerves tonight came from mostly the senior members of the team at Arkansas.
Well,
the
it's
younger
senior
generation.
Night.
Yeah, that's definitely contributing to it, I believe. Victoria Wynn, Emily Shield before her, 9.825.
It was just beautiful on this event. Very difficult, a noti into the back handspring.
Oh, that's rare in collegiate gymnastics, Kathy. It's a
absolutely
risky move, isn't it?
You have to be so on that difficult a noti. It's like a half turn into a front walkover, no room for error, and then you have to keep it going into the next skill to get the connection. Love her arms and hands, really beautiful expression. Nice work. So it's called an Anoti, half turn into a front walkover, keeps those arms moving, lines herself up perfectly.
Kennedy Hambrick here on senior night, hoping to finish off with a strong performance. She's had a bit of a difficult night.
Watch the height on this double back. back 1.5 to back layout, or front 1.5 to back layout, double stag jump. Here, taking deep breaths, getting ready for this pike double back. She's going to be happy with that. Great to see it. As we've talked about, it's been so challenging for this team throughout the season, managing all the COVID protocols when you're in and out of the gym, keeping up with the endurance it takes to do these floor routines can be challenging. And they're getting back to full strength. Wonderful to see.
Nice way to finish it off tonight for Kennedy Hambrick, the senior from Pearland, Texas on senior night. Haley DeYoung for Georgia. Georgia doing spectacularly well here. Victoria win 9-8-2-5. Georgia in a comfortable lead in the team competition.
Switch leap to split jump. Beautiful execution of those leaps. Nice toe point. Front aerial to straddle jump. Nice mixed series. Handspin layout, step out. Just a little bit of nerves creeped up right as she landed that element, but she fought through it. Side aerial to the full, see if she can get the stick. Really strong routine. I could see her managing the nerves as they crept up. Great to see her fight through them. Stay calm, stay aggressive. Nice 180 degree split, lines this up perfectly, just that slight slide back.
Kennedy Hambrick finished off her night extremely well with a 9-9-2-5, the senior. And here is Haley Lovett.
Big pass. Double layout.
Nice.
So strong.
She's been in the beam and floor lineup in every meet this year. Season high in this event, 9-9-2-5. So the senior from Greensboro, North Carolina, Bailey Lovett, could finish this off strong.
Double tuck. Look at the height. Really nice amplitude on both these passes. Switch half to straddle full. Watch the shapes in the air on these back-to-back layout somersaults. A little bit of arch on the first one. Routine. So happy to see these seniors having these moments. Nice job on the double layout. And amplitude on the leaps as well. Kept the toe point throughout Just a slight little arch and soft knees on that first somersault. Love the Fuete double stag out of the pass.
Rachel Bauman will wrap it up here, the final competitor for Georgia. Haley DeYoung before her, a 9.875. That is her season high.
Rachel is a beautiful beam worker, does a lot of difficulty in this routine. Her acro series is a side aerial, layout step out right here. Two somersaults in a row. The first one that actually turns in the air, love it.
Gymnastics enthusiasts will of course know that her sister Alyssa competes for Florida.
Both Bauman show such mastery on the qualities necessary for balance beam.
We said at the top of the show, Georgia hoping to focus on 0.025 per athlete. Just a little bit higher score, Georgia could break that 197 mark tonight.
Oh, the beam routine was so fantastic. They're going to have to deduct for the landing. She hopped forward out of the 1.5. But wow, the routine was so clean, so beautifully executed.
Final competitor for Arkansas tonight, another one of those graduate seniors, Sarah Schaefer. Haley Lovett, a 9.875 before her. Remember, they're trying to replace that 9.1 of Savannah Panizzi.
Back 1.5 front layout right to the corner. Strong finish. It's so wonderful to see senior magic. At least on three of the four events, it fueled them to really great performances. Went big, performed fully.
Well, that's our final competitor here tonight in this Arkansas-Georgia dual meet in the SEC. Georgia will get their first win in the SEC and will wrap up the final scores when we come back to Fayetteville. SEC Network, the number one South Carolina women's basketball team, heads to Ole Miss for the team's last game before the SEC Women's Basketball Tournament. Also available on the ESPN app. Well, here's the final score tonight from Fayetteville, Georgia. Remember, they were focused on that .025. Well, that 196.975 is their season high score, but guess what? They missed that magical 197 by .025. So Georgia, even though they get their first win in the SEC this season, they still have a few more .025s to work on. Arkansas, unfortunately, a bit of a rough night for several of the seniors, but good for Kennedy Hambrick, finished up strong on four on her last night here in Barnhill Arena with an outstanding job. So Arkansas yet to put together a complete meet. And I know that both of these coaches have been focused on dealing with injuries and COVID protocols and starts and stops throughout this season. I believe that Arkansas, it'll all come together, and they have a few more meets to get it done here before the end of the season and the SEC Championship, which of course we'll be covering all of the postseason extensively here on our ESPN family of networks. Kennedy Hambrick, the all-around winner tonight. One of seven seniors here for Arkansas who will be acknowledged and celebrated tonight for their terrific careers here as Razorbacks. So for Kathy Johnson Clark, I'm Bart Connor. We're glad you joined us here. Our final score once again, Georgia 196-975, Arkansas 196-1. Coming up next is SEC Inside Georgia Women's Basketball. So long from Fayetteville.